It's time now for a Sunday morning Q&A, and joining us this morning is Dr. Lillian Lowery, Maryland State Superintendent of Schools. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, tomorrow is a big day. Most Maryland students are heading back to class tomorrow.
Most of them are in, but a lot of the districts are opening tomorrow for the first time this year. People are excited.
Where did the summer go?
I know. It,
it just absolutely flew
by.
Well, one of the big things that's being instituted really everywhere is Common Core.
Right.
So how is that going so far with the teachers over the summer getting ready to implement this?
We had our third Educator Effectiveness Academy this summer, and I believe because we will be implementing fully in every school in the state, we really had people's attention. We've gotten great feedback. Every school had a team, including their administrators, for the training and the planning. And we are just excited that they are happy and pleased that these standards are going to yield great results for our students.
Well, it's really raising the bar for the kids. I mean,
absolutely.
Literally third graders are doing fifth grade math now. So this is, it's a lot for parents and teachers and students.
Right. And what I like to say when comments like that are made, because people do have to understand that, is if the adults are okay with it, our children are okay with it.
The adults can't do the math. I'm speaking from experience.
That's why we have great teachers in Maryland who can help us do that.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Let's talk about the new vaccination requirements for kids. I know that they implemented that and over the summer, and
right.
parents were needing to get on
right.
board with finding
right.
out if their kids needed an extra
right.
shot.
Right. The Department of Health and have now required that two doses of measles, rubella,
yes.
and what's the other one?
I know, I forgot the third one,
what's
too.
The third one? The MMR, will all students have to have two doses. And so we are checking records and working with families to make sure that we are supportive in making sure that happens. We have a great Department of Health, and they want to make sure that our children are safe and secure and that we are making sure that any kind of vaccinations that are needed will ensure safety and security for our students and health.
Safety and security. First mm-hmm. day of school tomorrow for Baltimore County. Last year didn't go very well at all.
Mm-hmm.
What's being done right now? Are you feeling good about tomorrow?
Oh, we're feeling good. I mean, I'm sure they felt really good last year about the opening of school.
Yeah.
We just don't know what external forces have out there waiting for us, but I will tell you that our superintendents and our school leaders and our teachers are certainly geared up and ready to go. As you know, the governor and the General Assembly awarded districts among the $25 million based on their requests, opportunities to shore up safety and security for schools. We have reviewed their plans with the Maryland State Police. We feel really good that we're ready, that we've been as preventive as we possibly can.
A couple weeks ago, we had Comptroller Peter Francho on our air, and he was talking about a study that he is behind, which is starting schools after Labor Day. How do you feel about this?
Well, there are strong voices on both sides, so I'm going to stay as neutral as I can until I hear from both sides. But there's a legislative task force that
mm-hmm.
has been seated, and we will be working throughout the year with that task force, which represents all elements, all segments of our society here in Maryland, and we will have recommendations ready for the governor and the General Assembly.
Okay, and you've been doing a lot with Facebook and social media, Twitter, trying to keep parents abreast. This is sort of exploding for the Maryland Department of Education as well.
Absolutely, and we have some great communications tools this year. It is so important, as everyone knows, as we go through the transition from our current standards to the Common Core State Standards and from our current assessments to new assessments, there is going to be some tough transitional periods and moments throughout this work, and we just want to prepare people to let them know that it's not unexpected and how we are going to mitigate the confidence in what we're doing with our children.
Weather's supposed to be great tomorrow for the first day of school, so that's always great for the kids and for the parents and for all the teachers heading back.
I know, and I heard that she encouraged students to make sure that they have some kind of wrap early in the morning because it may be a little
cooler. Chilly, but overall it should be pretty good.
No rain.
No
that's
rain.
Always good.
And you're going to be in the city tomorrow?
In Baltimore County.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good. Dr. Lowery, thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
Nice
I appreciate
to see you.
It.
You're
Have a
very
great
welcome.
School year.
Thank you. You
okay.
too. And